Assalamu alaikum. A very good morning to all of you. Today my topic is geometrical transformations. What are geometrical transformations? In mathematics, transforming an object means that you change its appearance, its shape, its size. Geometric transformations involve taking a pre-image, that is an object, and transforming it into some way to produce an image of that particular object. It might be a figure, it might be a object, like 3D objects. There are two different categories of transformation accordingly. Basically, the two types of transformations tells you how the orientation, size, shape of the object changes. First is isometric transformation. The word isometric comes from a Greek word and it meaning is having equal measure. It means when an object map from up on an image, so the measurements would not be changed. In isometric transformation, the shape is preserving or only the movement takes place. A non-isometric transformation. In such transformation, it does not preserve the shape or size of the object. Basically, today we are discussing only two types of transformation, and there are four types of transformation available in geometric transformations: refraction, rotation, translation, and enlargement. We treat reduction in mathematics as enlargement. The first three, refraction, rotation, and translation, are the isometric transformation. The shape and size will be preserved in these three transformations. But in the last transformation, that is enlargement, it is called a non-isometric transformation. We can enlarge the figure or reduce the figure according to the scale factor. Reflection. It is a map that transforms an object into its mirror image with respect to a mirror, which is hyperplane or fixed point in the geometry. In order to reflect a planar figure, one needs the mirror to be aligned. The main features of the reflection is the axis of reflection, the axis of symmetry you may say, or the line of reflection. While for reflection in the three-dimensional space, one would use a plane, the plane of reflection, or a symmetry, that is a rotational symmetry for a mirror. You can better understand the reflection through the four basic characteristics of a plane mirror. What happens when we observe our image in the plane mirror? Number one, an image in a plane mirror is the same size as the object. The image is upright. The location of the image is the opposite of the mirror relative to the object, and it is a virtual image. The same feature we will observe in case of reflection. This is a figure available for your convenience. The figure is ABC, that is the object, the original image. And the image after that object is on the right hand side, that is ADC. What happens in this case? We are treating the y-axis as a line of reflection. So the B point is reflected on D point, the A point reflected on the A point, and C is reflected on C. In such cases, when the y-axis is the line of reflection, so there will be no change in the y-coordinate, but x-coordinate changes. If it is x, so it becomes minus x. Another figure, the A, B, C, D, E, F is the object and it is reflected on A1, B1, C1, D1, E1, F1 image. Here the line y is equals to minus 6 is a line of reflection. This is the line. You can easily observe if object and image is available. So y is equals to minus 6 is a line. Here the two object and images are available and one can easily find out the line of reflection just by drawing a perpendicular bisector in between the points. We can take minimum two points or two pairs of points for calculating the line of reflection. It shows that how these two perpendicular bisectors are overlapped to each other. The second we are discussing here is rotation. It is performed by spinning the object around a fixed point known as the center of rotation. You may observe in the right side figure that a flag is available, an angle of reflection is 55 degrees and the direction of rotation is clockwise. The three main features are required for rotation. Those are point of rotation. You must know that on which point, on which axis you are rotating your object, the angle of rotation and the direction, either clockwise or counterclockwise. There are few images of rotation about the origin. In case of rotation, the quadrant may change if object is lying. Like in the first figure, rotation of 90 degrees, the triangle is available in the first quadrant, that is XY coordinate positive. But after the rotation 90 degree anti-clockwise, it has rotated in the fourth quadrant, that is A dash, B dash and C dash. There is a simple view that you can see how a figure transformed. What you have learned, can you find that this flower showing you a natural reflection? This is again the example of reflection in the nature. This is the rotation. Another example of rotation. The geometrical transformation in real life you have seen. These are the basic uses of geometrical transformations. You can use in construction a model, in editing of the model, using the commands like translate, rotate, zoom, mirror and array. You can use it in the computer graphics, the automotive industry for obtaining the orthograph, isometric and prospective views of any model, to view the model for the different positions and in the animations. Thank you.